Hello everyone, Lorenzo here from RVT. So, got a flat on my lawnmower, so I tried looking online to see if I can find anything about this product. It's by John Deere tire sealing. It's the TY26370, and I couldn't find anything, any videos or anything like that. So I'm gonna go ahead and try it and do a review on it to see how this thing holds up. And the tire got a flat over here. Now on the instructions, it says that I need to lift it off the ground. So the tire is like running freely right now. And according to the instructions, it says that it takes one bottle of that to fill this up. It's a 15 by 600-6. So that takes one. And then according to that instructions on the back over here, it says that the rear tire, my rear tire, is a 20 by 1000-8. That one takes two. So I'm gonna go ahead and just do the front one since this is the one that's flat and see how this thing works. Now I already opened it, I cut the top, and it came with this little thing right here. And it also came with the little straw right there. So according to instructions, it says that I need to remove the little thing over here. Just unscrews in. Just had to unscrew it. It's kind of hard to do with one hand, but little spigot thingy. Now take that out and then get the little straw, slide it on there. You come back over here, and according to the instructions, I'm gonna put it on the bottom so we can, if I can. It's kind of hard to do with one hand, sorry about that. So you squeeze the bottle, and you just squeeze it until you empty the whole bottle. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that. I might use both of my hands, so I'm gonna go ahead and stop it, and then once I get done with it, I continue recording. Be right back. Alright, so I'm done. I emptied the whole bottle over here, and guess I can go ahead and put the cap on it. But it's not really, we're not gonna use that anymore. So go ahead and take the straw out that came with it, and it says to wipe the excess from the from right here. It says to use a damp cloth, but then you can put the valve back in. Oh, valve, yeah, that's what it is. See, it just comes back to me. And then I'm gonna try to use this little pump to see if I can air it up like that. If not, I'm gonna have to get the compressor and see if I can. Well, I'm gonna try this first so I don't have to mess with the compressor. He says to just put air in it. I'm gonna go ahead and finish putting air in this. And it seems to be working right now, but I'm gonna see if I can get enough PSI in there. That require PSI. If not, I'm gonna have to come back and put more air in it. So I'll be right back. All right, so I go ahead and put the air in it and everything, and it only takes like 14 PSI, and this thing goes up to 120 PSI, so it worked pretty good. It's like a little foot pump. You just pump it right here. It's pretty good. I like it. I had it for a while now, but back to this. Well, we'll see what how this works, and I'll let you know in a week. I'm not gonna post this video yet until I actually do a full review on it. That way, you guys can have a full review in one video. So, see you about a week. All right, guys. So it's been a couple of weeks now. It's kind of windy out here, but the tire is still inflated. Usually it will go down in about a week or so. The tire will be flat, and I guess it will work if you have a small puncture on your wheel or something like that. I don't know how big the size of a hole it needs to be for it to be able to actually work on it, but I will say that it did pretty good. John Deere fix a flat or flat goo or whatever that thing is. But yeah, I mean, it's pretty good. So I hope you like this video and hope it helped some of you on this review on this product. So if you make sure you like and subscribe, and I guess I'll catch you on another video. Thank you for watching.